ever ship students?
Ship?
Mm-hmm. I understood that question.
I don't understand. Can you define that question?
And just so that we understand that, it's just two students that you see that you think maybe should be together, mm-hmm. right? Okay.
Do we ever what?
Yeah, I do. Do you ship students? Put them two together. Like, oh, this one and that one.
Oh, that kind of ship.
Here at school, do we do that? I've never done that.
No, I've never done that.
Yeah. I see, sometimes I think of kids that might be cool.
Yeah, something like that, like they might,
that's
yeah.
Shipping.
Yeah,
yeah, but like I would that, never yeah. say, hey.
No.
You know her, you know him, you guys should talk. Can we talk for a minute?
Have I thought that a couple of students would be compatible? Yeah, I think probably so. I don't think I do it often.
No.
I do, yeah. I know it before they know it, usually, yeah.
Yeah, I think that happens every once in a while. I don't think it happens every day, but every once in a while I'll see two students, I'm like, hey, you guys would be pretty good together, so I think it happens.
Well, I mean, we are chemistry teachers.
That's
so
right.
An expertise.
And opposites do attract, right?
Absolutely.
All right.
I think people, not even high school students, but people in general, don't know what's good for them until they're 34.
Have you ever been asked to help interfere in students' love lives?
like a student might come up and ask, like, or like tell a story about what's going on in their love life, but I mean,
that's a tough one.
No. I don't think so.
No.
Yeah.
No.
No, I usually get told not to meddle. Just kidding.
I've never been asked to interfere, but I have been told quite a few stories about what's going on and asked for lots of advice. I don't know if I'm the best person for advice, but I've been asked for advice.
Yeah, and I certainly see students that are upset, mm-hmm. that they're emotional, and I try to, you know, just let them know it's going to be okay, and just kind of tell them to keep moving forward.
How should you break up with someone?
Fast.
Talk to them. Communication.
Face to face. Conversation.
Yeah, conversation.
No texts. Certainly not Snapchat.
Yeah, none of that. That Facebook. Was harsh. Yeah, oh my God. That, Twitter like, and all that. Like, oh my God. Especially like when you're.
I don't want to date you anymore as part of my story for 24 hours.
I've never broken up with anybody. I've either like waited it out so that somebody would break up with me or I moved away.
Yeah, I think relocating to another city is your best bet. And
it
just
works like a dream.
I thought this was like romance Valentine's here. Wow.
Is everything okay with Freddy on the Hawk? Is that where these,
a lot of
are these questions coming from? Everybody's all right?
Maybe I'll take this one.
I
just think, you know, on Valentine's Day, it's all about respect, right? It's all about the dignity of a person. And I think if you keep those two words in mind, if things aren't working out, just be respectful and make sure that you treat that person in a kindly way.
Texting, obviously.
Obviously. Preferably just stop texting them back and move.
Yeah. Relocate.
Probably is how you, yeah. Change your name.
Ghosting.
In extreme cases.
Ghosting.
Yeah, I think that's what they call it now. Before it was just like getting a new social security number.
If you are considering yourself mature enough to be in a relationship, you should be mature enough to handle said relationship when it is over.
When is the right time to meet the parents and how should I do it?
Sooner than later. I mean, you kind of want to establish that relationship, I think. And then the same thing, face to face. You know, you kind of have that, sit down with the mom and dad, kind of maybe have a dinner, maybe go out, something like that. But definitely sooner than later.
In high school, parents are a big part of the equation. You need to get them on your side. And so I think, like, early, even before maybe you know that you are overly affectionate with their progeny.
Well, mostly because like you need rides and stuff. It would be pretty hard, I think, to avoid meeting parents in high school.
I assume you like shake hands and say hi and like.
But I mean, like,
do we need dinner or a movie or?
You know, I think the ideal meeting of the parents is at homecoming, mm-hmm. when you show up to her door, and then it turns out that the guy who answers the door is actually your...
The love advice expert, Mr. Yep. Weld.
We call him the love guru up in chemistry.
What is the weirdest thing you have seen a couple do in your class?
Second year of teaching, I actually had two students that were actually legally married. They were 16 years old, and they actually had permission from their family. And so they were actually married, sitting right next to each other, second year teacher in my classroom. And I thought, wow, I don't know if I'll ever see that again.
In my class, sit on top of each other.
I have two that just sparked recently. One where they sat close to each other, like closer. I don't know, somehow I'm like, we have a seating assignment, but you know, I guess it was disregarded. But anyways, I was like, dude, I feel like I'm a third wheel. And then I'm like, no, this is not a date. And they're looking at me like, what? I'm like,
weird? I'm
going. Yeah.
Holding hands the whole time, like holding hands during class, like across a row. So strange.
Usually if I see any PDA.
Adorable, but very weird.
If I see any PDA, I usually mime having a spray bottle like a cat. One day I want to get one.
I see more of you in the hallway.
I try not to look, so. I see a lot of weird
making out, probably just making out, but I don't think that's kind of weird. I mean, that's not weird to you guys, but. Public affair.
Kind of in the hallway.
Yeah, call. I mean, I kind of like.
Like, there's 1,600 kids.
Like yesterday, okay, speaking of that, yesterday in the lunchroom, the couple, they were in the line. Like, this physical kind of like, it was, I was, and I kind of went over, like, hey, let's kind of knock it off. But it was in the lunch line during the lunch. So.
The weirdest thing is when people sit on each other's laps, though.
It's weird.
It's casual.
It's weird.
I don't like the snuggling. I mean, it's not weird, but when they get a little lovey-dovey snuggling, you know, it's...
I mean, it's not like it's inherently weird, but for class, it's pretty weird when people come in and sitting on each other's lap.
Is there such a thing as a serious high school relationship?
Look at your face. Yes, there is.
Yeah, I believe so. It can be. If both people are committed and serious about what they want to do, I think, yeah, definitely.
Absolutely. I think you can have a serious relationship, and I don't think it has to necessarily... I don't think age is a thing. I think it has to do with probably how much you're committed to the other person and what you're willing to essentially go through to make a relationship work. Is that a good answer?
Yeah.
I thought so, yeah.
For sure, yes. Love can be a very serious game that should be taken seriously when you're young.
What should I get my significant other for Valentine's Day?
I'm a big fan of sweaters.
I was gonna say I'm a big fan of perishable or consumable items or experiences.
Nothing. I have never gotten my significant other something for Valentine's Day because I think Valentine's Day is this corporate holiday where they jack up the prices of flowers and candy. And so my thing is, let's treat your significant other great 365 days out of the year rather than one day.
Your heart, literally.
Flowers. I go flowers and chocolate. Ooh. Solid. You know, it's cliche, really? but do you know, it's the delivery that matters. Like last year I had my kid surprise my wife when she was teaching another class in a public setting, and it got her. Yeah. Like I think the surprise and delivery of the flowers and chocolate is more important than the cliche flowers and chocolate.
Girls like flowers.
Gotta get flowers.
Gotta get flowers.
Some roses.
Roses. Maybe candy.
Candy.
Box of chocolates.
What are the best pickup lines you know, and say them to each other?
You guys have any good ones?
Do you want to study chemistry?
Sure. Oh, that was it?
Are you tired? You run into my mind all day.
Here's the thing I'll say on that. It's not a pickup line, but I do recommend, will you go out on a date with me?
Hey.
I think hey in his mind. Like what I got.
Ay, ay, ay.
Oh, no. My best baby.
I didn't have to use any.
Yeah, I don't. Yeah.
I mean, hate the sound.
No, it sounds. It sounds. Yeah, but no. I wait for them. I don't. I don't do it.
So there's only one that I really think is good, and you just need. You need to get a bunch of limes, and then just go find that person, and then just like drop all your limes on the ground, and then just like pick up your limes, and spend like 20, 30 minutes just struggling to like pick up and drop these limes, and then look them in the face and just say, "Sorry, I'm bad at pick up limes."
That's good, Mr. Welp. I like that.
Yeah.